and it's still the same now. Better than my black trench vest. You gotta be down there, bang bang. Come and get this teaching, your soldiers. Hot dogs, dust, mustache. Me drinking, me broke to my stomach. Big blue on the way back.
You already know what it is, man. On a Tuesday night, this is the best late night show on the internet, man. DJ Sings over there turned up, literally. We happy to be back in the building, man. DJ Sings, Bree, what's up, man? We got the team in here right now. Condo TV is live. Condo TV is hot. We in here. We was off last week, though.
We had a little break.
Yeah, we had a little break, man. I wanted to, you know, give y'all a chance to get refreshed.
Yeah.
Get your mind right. Okay. Coming off the Labor Day weekend, right. Shit like that.
Okay.
Right. A lot of y'all drunk, a lot of libations. You know, y'all turned up to the max.
I think I had one drink.
Where were you at?
I was in Chicago.
Chi-town, shouting. Southside, Chi? Mm-hmm.
No, not.
You don't know where you was
not,
at?
Not
I'm about to say, because you don't know what color
I was
you
in the
there.
City.
You might get too out of frame out there.
Not on
Make
the
Make sure
side.
Your appropriateness is together.
But I was in the city. My brother was, we were upstate for a karate tournament.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So my dad got promoted. My brother got promoted. My uncle got promoted.
Okay.
So.
Shout out to the
how
karate
did, now, how did your brother do, man? He didn't go there and get his ass tore up, did he?
Oh,
did he
no, kick ass? Of course not. Yes, always.
Yeah. You know, that's what they always say. That's your brother.
He go, always kicks ass.
Has he ever lost? Your brother don't ever lose, do
yes, he has lost.
How many times he lost? Two?
No, maybe like 15.
Oh, okay. Oh. So he got what it takes to become a great fighter one day.
Right.
Oh, yeah. That's what's up.
Yeah.
Shout out to the karate kid.
Yeah.
Keep on fighting, man. Don't you ever give up, because all my life, I had to DJ Sings, what's good, man?
Man, listen, everybody wants kung fu. I'm just playing.
What you got going on over there?
Yo, man, I'm happy to be back. Whenever we go on for like a week, it feels like it's been like a month.
Right.
So I'm just shouting out to everybody that's been rocking with us. I'm happy to be back. Tonight's show is gonna be insane, man.
It's crazy.
I don't even want to get too far in it because everybody need to stop what they're doing right now. Retweet the link. Let's get everybody in the room because y'all do not want to miss this show.
Big bro, when I tell you, man, I've assembled a great panel of gentlemen that I called. And, you know, you got to represent for the ladies, too.
But this is new for me because I wasn't here when y'all did the first one.
Right. So we took advantage of her being out of town the first time.
Right, so they just said, we're going to do it for the fellas. Kick me out.
Right.
But
now you're here.
Now I'm here.
So now you're the voice of the female tonight.
Exactly.
All right, so what's going down? What Black Men Really Think, part two. Y'all asked about it. Y'all was with me on Twitter. Y'all was Facebooking me. Y'all was Instagramming me. We finally got it together. What Black Men Really Think, part two, goes down, man. The team is here. They're strong. Hey, man, it's going to be a hell of a show. Y'all ready to get into it?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Hey, man, we got What's Popping in the Streets with Bree coming up next. Entertainment news. It was crazy. I got to figure out what's going on with Gucci, man.
We're going to talk about that because I don't really know. But we're going
to
talk about it.
We got to. Man, this Condo TV Live. Make sure y'all stay tuned. Retweet the link, man. Hey, we just getting started in here right now. Condo TV Live, we in here. Y'all stay tuned. Let's go.
No girl can freak me, I'm just too nasty. Lost on the dance floors, I attack y'all. Snuck through the back door, guess who they saw? Goldie and Ghost, Black African Rope. Star studded lowlands, plus the mural was dope. Airbrush WB, stop.
Shake your body.
And cop a couple of these.
She's a hottie.
Godfrey and Chauncey. Very upset.
For what?
Doing, put a rough rider on my bus right through him. Come out your shirt, insert the party rhyme. Fire Dr. Berserk, Bacardi Lime. With passionate taste to shake your Calvin Klein before the floor gets moist. Case and follow mine. Swallow nine, model dimes from Bahamas. Slim doodle makers stuffed inside pajamas.
Tony's in.
back to Condo TV Live. We are in the building once again, man. Bree, I know it's been a lot of stuff to go on. I mean, you got 2 weeks of stuff. I mean, I know you've been busy and all that, but I know
not a whole
that you've got to bless us with this entertainment news, man.
I can
tell
y'all out. There's stuff in the streets
that we got to know about.
But first of all, let's talk about how was your holiday?
My holiday, it was cool, man. It was cool. I was drunk a lot.
Yeah.
You that's too? What Darren said. Both of y'all was drunk?
Yeah, yeah, that sounds about right. Drunk. Yeah.
When I tell you the libation was heavily flowing through my veins, and I was on level 10 at all times, man. Shout out to Southern Culture. I got to do that. I got to shout Southern Culture out, man. My dog, Dion, MJ, Cookie, Sav, Mr. Pulliam. The whole crew, man. It was crazy.
Yeah.
It was crazy. We was at the Braves, man, tailgating, man. It was live. You know what I'm saying? I'm on the Sweetwater. It's crazy. 420. All that. It was crazy, man. It was all the way
down. I heard that weekend. I mean, I wasn't here. They had a little bar crawl and all that. I missed all that, huh?
Oh, man. When I tell you the bar crawl in Buckhead was crazy.
I heard everybody was out there.
So it was the official SEC kickoff. So that was the week that Alabama played Virginia Tech.
Right.
When I tell you that shit was so live, man, I'm talking about my foot on the ceiling in there. I'm talking about panties and skirts up.
I saw everybody on Instagram talking about it, and I'm in my hotel room in Chicago like, damn. I could be really drunk right now. Really drunk.
I was handling family stuff.
But I was.
Yeah. And plus, you know, you got plenty of time to get drunk.
Of course. Yeah, of course. Any day.
So what's good?
But just like y'all got really drunk, Lamar Odom got arrested for a DUI on Monday because he was drunk.
What a segue.
Driving home at like 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yes.
Driving irately.
Driving irately.
Irately.
Yeah.
And,
no, you know what? I heard he was driving slow.
No, I heard he was like this.
Well, shit, that nigga, we don't know what the hell he was doing.
And then when they pulled him over, he was talking like a snake, like.
Hey, man.
He had a snake tongue.
He had a snake list.
He had the Java going on from Aladdin.
And that bath salt.
He had the serpent.
That bath salt ain't what's up, man. Lamar, you got to stop that.
Man, did y'all see the picture of my man on the Instagram where he was my man from
Dave Chappelle.
Dave Chappelle.
Yeah. With the lip.
What was the crackhead name from Dave Chappelle?
Tyrone Biggums.
It was like Lamar Biggums. They had my man with the red beanie on, man. With the crusty mouth.
Poor Lamar.
But Mount Gain was crusty. No Carmex.
No, nothing.
What we got, man? What Lamar got going on?
But next, you know, during the VMAs, they had A$AP Rocky presents. Not present. He actually was going to.
I know where this is going.
Yeah, you know where it's going, right?
I know exactly.
Him and Jason Collins was up on the stage, and they were getting ready to present for. What is his freaking name? Macklemore and Ryan Lewis. They're bringing them up because they're getting ready to perform. So he was saying, A$AP Rocky was saying, you know, this artist, he feels the same way as everybody else does about, you know, same sex and gay marriage and all that stuff. Uh-huh. And he said homosexuality and pointed at Jason Collins. Like,
I don't know if y'all saw the video, though. That shit was so crazy.
I watched it. Man. The inmates. So.
Bro, say it don't matter if you gay, straight, homosexual. I said, God. Russ said, homosexual. I said, oh, man.
He pointed.
How you feeling?
He pointed.
But Jason Collins' face,
everybody
though?
Laughed. He was very embarrassed. Everybody laughed. But he did apologize for it. It was his.
Oh, he said he was sorry.
He said he was really sorry about it. Man. And he was upset that his facial expressions and what he did kind of gave that.
Right.
Gave that off that he was, you know,
so that means he all the way out. Yeah.
I don't know. But.
Who, Jason?
Yeah.
Jason all the way out.
All the way out. He came out.
No, Jason he was looking like, oh, shit, too. He was looking like.
But it's embarrassing. That's embarrassing.
But you out, though. That you out? Nah. You supposed to be out.
Listen,
but that's
what you
embarrassing.
Get embarrassed for?
That's embarrassing.
He out. Sweater tight and all. The man, he's out.
Man, look here. See, you can't be a bulldagger talking about, you know what I'm saying? See, that how it is when you're bulldagger, though.
Leave that man alone.
I'm just saying.
Leave that man alone.
Come on, ASAP, man. Who he said he was sorry to? He apologized?
Everybody.
Damn.
That's rude and disrespectful.
It is what it is.
But so what's going on with this Gucci man?
Wow.
Gucci man.
Gucci.
So he got on Twitter and got on this, you know, Twitter rant about how he smashed Monica and Nicki Minaj and Tyga's baby mama and all the people from everybody in Atlanta, basically.
So from what I'm hearing that Gucci wasn't the one that was sending the tweets, though. I heard it was like Gucci brother or something like that. Cause I could be wrong. They say that Gucci was not sending the tweets. But now, We know Gucci represents Zone 6. Shout out all day. I mean, I don't know what high school he went to. I ain't down to nobody high school. But bro looked like he, you know how to, you know, sentence structure was way off.
Sentence structure?
Yeah. Yeah.
That wasn't no damn, it wasn't no sentences. Wasn't no sentences.
When I,
it was just words.
It was periods. I mean, periods were
words.
Where commas supposed to go. It was just all wrong.
Exclamation marks.
Yeah. What question mark supposed to be at.
Right.
I was like, Gucci, man, come on, man.
Listen, your spelling game. We got to do better about this spelling, man. Come on. All the letters, when you spell a word, you're supposed to put the letters behind each other, brother. Don't put spaces in between each the one. Letters in one word.
He tried.
No.
Gucci, tried. Come on, man.
But then Tiger came back with a tweet saying that he has HIV.
But you know, that's what they say when they feel slighted in some kind of way. Oh, man, you gay. He got to be gay.
I don't know. That's what they say. HIV. I don't know if he's gay.
Oh, my goodness.
But.
Say he gay, he got AIDS. See, that what they say?
No, he didn't say that. He just said he got HIV.
You cannot make it in the industry unless you gay and got AIDS. One of the two. That's what I'm saying.
So.
This is crazy out here.
So, according to Gucci, he has smashed the entire city of Atlanta. If you have a vagina and
your
Gucci
mama,
has not smashed
your
you yet, you will be smashed.
Your auntie.
Within the next 48 hours. I can assure you, Gucci everybody. Will smash you within 48 hours. It's happening. It's going down.
I mean, you know shit. You know he said he got that yellow booty, so they say when he like them yellow booty, man, that's what they say.
That's nasty.
Yellow everything, man. Lemonade. Fruit cup. What they call it? Free cup. Lemon pepper wing. Lemon booty hole. That's what he like.
Yeah, I'm good on that.
That's it.
Gucci! Burr. Shout, but shout. We in here.
Stop.
Classic.
That's enough. That's all enough. Right. Okay, and then lastly, have you guys heard about this million Muslim march that's supposed to be going on tomorrow?
I have not heard about that.
I guess first it was some bikers that wanted to ride on the Capitol. So it'd be like 2 million bikers supposed to be riding on the Capitol on September 11th.
Okay.
But they got denied and they allowed the Muslims to have their march on the Capitol on September 11th.
Wow.
So they got the Muslims marching on Washington on September 11th instead of the bikers.
Right.
Ironic. The irony right there.
Yes.
I know the SWAT team and the bomb squad are going to be heavy out that thing.
Because, bro. Only because the bikers say they're going to come through anyway on their bikes.
Ooh.
So, I don't know what's going to happen.
The jihad is going to be for real. I'm telling you.
I don't. Not.
The jihad is going to be
crazy. But it's just,
right now.
I don't know. I do think that they.
Muslims. I'm talking about Sons of Anarchy.
I do think that they're doing this for peace,
like,
and it's a good cause, but it's just the wrong day.
Ooh. So you got mothers that done travel for miles from the Mecca that's going to meet up with Sons of Anarchy.
And they tomorrow.
So this is my question.
On the day that the Twin Towers went down.
Right.
The Twin Towers.
Right.
I would have loved to have been in that meeting when they all got together and said, all right, this is it. We got a march on Washington. What day we going to do it on? I got it. Pick me. I got it. 9/11.
Dog, that's a good ass
that's
idea
day.
Right now.
That's what we gonna do.
I think maybe they're trying to show America that they're, you know,
patriotic?
No, I guess and that they're nonviolent. You know what I mean?
I ain't gonna
like not everybody who's Muslim is a terrorist.
True indeed.
We're not saying that.
Let's get that clear. Everybody that's of Muslim beliefs. We're not talking about the ones that really practice the religion and do the right thing. We're talking about the one that's out here blowing themselves up. Now we ain't got time for that shit there. I ain't got time for that shit there. Take your ass over here, blow your own damn self up. We trying to live out here. All right. If I see you out with a book bag, and some place
book bag,
all that shit.
But we gonna see tomorrow what tell actually your ass happens. Up. I don't know. I hope nobody gets hurt or shot. Cause it's supposed to be like the Mongols and Hell's Angels, all them people.
Wow. Really, Sons of Anarchy though.
Yes.
Sheesh.
They supposed to ride anyway. They was like, fuck y'all.
Well,
we gonna ride
on the Muslims,
right? So hopefully nobody gets killed. And that's it. That's it. That's all I got for this week.
I know you got to reel this rule.
I do, kind of.
Give me something though. And you haven't gave me a number in so long. No, I need a number from you. You got to throw something out there.
Number 11.
Okay.
This is Brioli's rule number 11.
Here we go. Pay attention.
I don't even want to say the N word.
Yeah.
Just don't hate on somebody else's hustle. When you don't have your shit together.
Wow.
Bars.
There it is.
Say that again. Say that one more time.
Don't hate on somebody else's hustle when you don't have your shit together.
Message.
if you at home with your mama, if you ugly, if whatever.
Not if you ugly.
If you ugly.
Now, see, like, it's a lot of things you can change in life. Nah, you can change.
If you're ugly, you do not hate on somebody else's shit.
You can change being fat. And you know what? And you know what, though? And you know what, though? In some cases, you probably can change being ugly. But no. Plastic surgery won't cover all that, baby.
Exactly.
No. I'm sorry.
Don't hate on somebody else's shit.
Period. Good one. That was a good
rule. I love that.
Good rule.
I love that. You already know what it is, man. Condo TV Live. We are in the building, man. I got to say it about 2-3 times, man. I see y'all in the chat room going crazy right now. Make sure y'all set up on the Count With You stream. Come into the chat room. We want to hear your thoughts, man. We want to hear, see, taste your thoughts, all that, man. It's Condo TV.
What?
You better get it together, man. You better get it together. It's going down in here right now. Condo TV Live. When we come back, hey, man, DJ C is going to bless us with that music news. You ready for that, bro?
Hey, it's go time. Let's do it.
Man, bro, over there going in, man. It's Condo Scenes, man. Condo and Scenes TV, Bree TV, all that shit, man. The damn Merlot was talking. It's in here, man. Condo TV Live. Y'all stay tuned.
So you know I trouble this eye. No lizard, I'm his eye. Like hell, I believe I can fizz eye. And yeah, I'll see you later.
Big up to all my haters.
Got your woman, dog, yep. Or I'll take her. You'll hear a scream from College Park to Decatur. I was a snotty nose with no paper. Now my crib sitting on 22 acres. Get it right, fool, I get money. If you think loot is not filthy, use a dummy. I was allergic to the roof on the cutty, so I took the top off like a Playboy bunny. Catch me pimping in a robe and some slippers. Riding down 85 while I'm stunting on my Gixxer. Mouth full of Swishers, or riding with your sister. And 6 David Beckhams or a trunk full of kickers. Take a picture of the mister, it'll last long. And these haters get stretched out like a bad thong. So partner, mash on, or get mashed up. Think you could with Luda then put a million of your cash up. Hi, hello.
Welcome back once again to Condo TV Live. It's now time for DJ Scenes to bless us with that music news. It's Tuesday.
It is Tuesday.
I know we got new albums that came out. I know you got some heat over there for your boys, man. What's good, man?
Well, people out there in Condo TV land, welcome back. Yes, it is Tuesday, and we have some new music that came out today.
Yeah, all that.
Couple new albums. Yo, let me jump right in. 2 Chainz, Bolts 2, based on the true story, part 2.
Me Time.
Had a chance to, preview the album today. I'm feeling it. I mean, this is the thing, man. From somebody that's like 2 Chainz since Player Circle, like from way back when, you getting more of the same. You definitely can hear that, you know, 2 Chainz is evolving, like with the selection of tracks that he's picking. Mm-hmm. But you know, that raw gutter street, that titty too, you're gonna get all that.
Yeah,
you're gonna get all that.
I must say though, bro, I think I'm really I'm proud of 2 Chainz, man. Mean, to see where he came from. Then, you know, we got to turn up because he's Southside Shouting.
Southside Shouting.
You got to, man.
Used to play basketball in Birdhead Gym.
I'm telling you. It's like that, man.
Oh,
Chainz, Tit, we salute you, man. I heard they got a big party tonight at Compound. They about to turn up.
Okay.
And one of my Morehouse brothers, man, is his road manager. Shout out to Steve, man. Cash. It's crazy. They about to get ready to go win. My man posted the Instagram today. He said he about to walk in Compound with a camel. Yeah. The camel from the commercial. It's Hump Day. That same camel. The same camel, dude. I said, man, where y'all get this cat?
Hey, man.
Y'all better be on level 20 in that thing, dude.
Hey, turn up
the 2 Chainz, man. Salute. I love it.
So yeah, both two came out today. Also, Janelle Monae, man. Janelle Monae's album came out. The Electric Lady, cold-blooded. Listen, yeah. I'm telling you, good listening music. It's a song. She got a song on there with Miguel. She has a song on there featuring Esperanza Spalding.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
She's dope.
Yo,
she's mad dope.
It's called, the name of the song is called Dorothy Dandridge's Eyes. Just listen to it. All I can say is just listen to it. It'll blow your mind.
Yeah.
Janelle sounds better than she's ever sounded. I mean, she always sounded good, but she's definitely at her peak.
Sing. Stop right there.
Yeah.
Dude, when I tell you, Janelle Monae, though, dude, been rocking with her since the AUC days.
Yeah, man. Old school.
I heard of Janelle Monae back in 2002. You know what I'm saying? Back when she had big ass puffy hair. Back when she wore colors a little bit. She wasn't wearing all black and white back in then. You know what I'm saying? Somebody know about Janelle Monae in the AUC. It was crazy. So to see what she had now, she went and got on with Purple Ribbon. We're fooling with Big Boy for a while. Then she went up and got a distribution deal with our Bad Boy. It's crazy, man. Janelle Monae is like number one chick in the game, like when it comes to that genre of music. It's crazy. I love her. She getting crazy feet. Her feet game crazy.
Yeah,
she dance up under the table.
Yeah, you don't want none, you don't want to pause
like
that.
James Brown.
I'm telling you, that her cousin crazy.
Also, the Weeknd's album also came out. I didn't get a chance to listen to that one, but for those that are the Weeknd fans, make sure you go and pick that up and support my man. I'm gonna get right into the heat of the week.
Here we go.
The heat of the week comes from Boats 2 off 2 Chainz album. The name of the song is called "I Do It," featuring Drake and Lil Wayne. Listen, I just need y'all to understand something. When it's time for you to turn up, and I can say this as I have Jägermeister in my cup. When it's time to turn up, this is the song that you need to cut on for this week. Now, y'all know how we do it, so I'm going to go on and jump right in.
Here we go, Bishop.
Now, you ain't going to believe this shit. Now, these are lyrics. Hold on. You thought last week was something? This is some real shit coming up right here. Let me tell you, this is how 2 Chainz start off the song. The song starts off like this. Stay with me now. It says, "Thank God for the first nigga that started drinking."
Oh.
"Thank God for the first nigga that started rapping. Thank God for the first girl to start stripping."
Now, these are profound words, see?
"I'm going to have to keep it motherfucking real with him." Let me read that again. "I'm going to have to keep it motherfucking real with them. I got a problem with these niggas. I got a problem with these bitches. Trigger finger keep itching. I pull it. I do it." I ain't make that shit up. It's in the text.
It's in the text. It's in the text.
You can look it up and Google it.
Now, hold on, Bishop Sings. Now, can you give me a little bit of verse 2?
Verse 2. Just a little bit.
That's a tad.
It start off like this and say, "Hey, hang up on a bitch. Call it crucified. Time to go to work, no suit and tie. Bubba Max Machiavelli, I be trapping at the telly. My nigga did a dime and he back already." Boom. I didn't make this up. You can read it.
Yes.
It's in the text.
This
so
is
shout out to 2 Chainz, Drake, Lil Wayne, "I Do It." Obviously, you should be extremely inebriated when you listen to this.
Yes.
Obviously.
So what's good stripper music? Jager in the building, man. I want to give a shout out to the Prophet Titty Boy.
That's the heat of the week.
For turning up, man. That was crazy. That was one of the best heat of the week we done ever had right there. It's crazy.
Hey, that's it.
Man.
That's the heat.
Woo! DJ Sings, appreciate that, brother. That was dope. Hey, man. Condo TV Live, we in the building. Bree, Sings, the whole team, we in here. Y'all know it's time. When we get back, y'all saw the topics all over the social networks, man. It's about to go down. I got my guests in the building, man. I got my dog, Tonio Terry. Is it cool to see your whole name? Don't say your whole name. Tonio Terry, a.k.a. King Beef, as they call him, in the building. We got Junkie Jarve, my dog, Deion Glover, in the building. We also got my dog, Simon Stone, up in here. We about to get it in, man. It's time to get real in here with these women folks about what we men feel about certain issues, man. It's going down. Yeah, I said it. I done said it. Condo TV it. Live. Y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. Come on back, man. Let's go.
My jeans are coming apart.
You see me, I eat, sleep, shit, and talk rap. You see that 98 Mercedes on TV, I bought that. I had some felony charges, I bought that. Been sent to no return, but still was ball back. Nigga threw some slangs in me, Woody, I called that. I punished them the bitches before they could call Jack. Now I'm looking for their family and partners to wall back. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call that? Nigga disrespect me, I'ma be in all black. Coming in by some niggas about killing and all that. Nico and Rusty and Doug Dog. Ride top down so we let the trucks pause. MMT riding 4 deep. I booted up at these niggas claiming they know me. I'll bust your ass up. Don't even go there, Woody, cause I'm ready to mass up. I heard about the money, that's a nice change.
for the right price, I bust the right brand. All of these niggas try, I can't do the right thing. Only God knows what the future might bring. Nigga might be shy, nigga might be trifling. Nigga might survive if he bought that right fling. With something that'll stop a nigga from playing. Something like a child or a grenade in his hand. Boy, look, nigga don't play no games no more. Nigga, a bust your head if you bang his hole. Attitude adjustments that y'all need. My calling door enforcements, nigga call me. I bet ya I get them niggas off your block. I bet ya I show them niggas this boy hot. Alright, stop it, cause I done had enough. When it comes to my pockets, I'm ready to bust. Baby, let me get the keys to the Rover truck. Man, let me get this beef shit over, bruh. Ain't no bit this year, I'm from the lawyer, bruh. What should be paid, is what was told to us. I'ma be running with these killers and banging down. I'ma look in front of my people like a clown. The G-code that we live by and we die by. The book is what we never will abide by. Niggas drive by, getting loose. Beefing with each other like a checkerboard and goose. Up in Compton, or the wise nigga. Up in New York, you keep a moving watch, nigga. Boy, you get played by a bitter Italian. All fine young black female stallion. Give me the keys to your car and your medallion. You far away from your home using alien.
Running to you, baby, baby, baby. These feelings.
are back in the building right now. We have reached the pinnacle of the show, man. When I tell you I'm excited about what's about to take place right here, it's about to be off the chain. Once again, you saw it on the Twitter, you saw it on the Facebook, you saw it on the Instagram, man, all the social networks. We are dealing with What Black Men Really Think Part 2 going on, because the request was so high the first time. Wow. Folks was like, man, look, we got to do this again. Wow. I got some unanswered questions that I need to get the answer to. It's going down right now, man. So let me introduce my esteemed panel right now. Let me go ahead and do that, man. You've seen this gentleman right beside me before. I mean, front man, hip-hop, rock artist, man, dope brother. When I tell you, man, y'all got to make some noise for my dog, Simon Stone, in the building, man.
Kenpo, what's up?
And we gonna swing around. We're going to swing around to the right over here. This gentleman right here, man, is one of the funniest cats I know. One of the realest cats I know. My big bro, Khaled Park, representative. Banneker High School, class 99, is in the building, represented to the fullest, man. It's crazy right now, man. Y'all make some noise. Social media funny, man. Antonio King Beef Terry in the building, y'all.
Yeah. Woo.
And once again, man, we're going to slide this thing over to my left, my immediate left right now. You've seen this gentleman before. I mean, he was on our What to Wear, What Not to Wear fashion episode about a month and a half, 2 months ago, right? It was like that, man. I mean, one of the rawest wardrobe stylists you're going to find in the country. Y'all better get at him, man. He going to share some light on what's going on with these women folk, man. Make some noise for my dog, Dion Junkie Java Glover, in the building.
Woo!
My dog, we in here. So fellas, I had to bring the team together. I had to assemble a great crew.
It's like Voltron.
You know, it's crazy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like Captain Planet.
Yeah.
When our powers combine, it's like that. I mean, we did part one. You were actually the part one.
Absolutely.
Which was an amazing episode. And then we went right off to the part one and went to the women.
Right.
Black women really think. And that was a crazy show. So we had to bring the fellas back. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, bro. We got anytime, man. You know, we got the Team Dastardly is here.
Team Dastardly is
in the building.
Yeah.
Definitely in the building, man. So, fellas, I got to start this thing off right, man. I got to start this thing off right, because we all on social network, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And I see a lot of y'all post. You know what I'm saying? But it's just something in particular that kind of throw me off all the time. What's up with the thirst traps that the ladies be setting, man?
Oh, no.
Why are the thirst traps so real? You know what I'm saying? But they work like crazy. But then when they put the thirst trap up there, when you see that person in person, they don't want to get the attention. You know what I'm saying? They don't like the attention that they get from the thirst trap that they set up.
You
like,
know,
really? You don't pull the wool over my eyes. You have behooved me.
You've been hoodwinked.
I've been bamboozled.
What you got?
What a muck. Huh? Thirst trap didn't land on me. I landed on the third trap. Give me something. What you got? I mean,
you know,
I'm going to start with you.
You know what? Look at it like this. You had, let's say, even dudes, it go both ways. But you get a girl, she was never really that popular in high school. She is an adult, even in college. She was that chick that nobody really invited to the party. She wasn't that cool, wasn't that popular, what have you. Mm. All of a sudden, now you got social media. She can put up a picture, take it from the right angle, show a little bit of boob, bitch, you know what I'm saying?
Side boob.
Got a dude like, my, you the finest thing I ever seen. That got to feel good for somebody like that. Like, yeah. Like, I ain't going to say no name, but somebody say, you know, sometimes you're ugly and sometimes the game ain't in order.
Exactly. I don't understand that, man. Like,
but it actually makes perfect sense, because how else would she get attention?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm gonna try to. These lights are so bright, y'all. That's why I had my glasses on. But she never had attention before, so now she has a form. Not only can she get attention, but she can get, you know, 100 likes. That's like more than she ever got in her lifetime. You know what I'm saying? So now she feeling like Froggy. But then when she see you in person, she know, damn, he gonna know I ain't got my shit together. You know, my
that's what I'm saying.
Bad, you know
the thing
saying?
About it is, a lot of times, ladies, we know you in real life. So we know you ain't about that life. And you out here setting the thirst trap, and we see you with double D's, because you got the Victoria's Secret sale push-up bra on. You don't miss all that shit right there. See, that's what I'm saying. Don't co-sign.
You don't say. Say it again, girl.
I mean, I'm just saying. Tony, how you feel about that? Because I know you be saying it, bro.
Man.
Hey. Which is, that's
wait
okay.
a minute. Shots are being fired, y'all.
But we didn't create the thirst, though. Y'all did. Anyway, go ahead.
I just seen a couple of Instagram superstars riding down Peachtree with that Breeze card down there. So I don't know what the hell that's all about. All I know is this. I mean, they say it's a thirst trap for men, but at the end of the day, if you show your ass, you show your titties. Any nigga that's got some business about himself that like women, like I like women, then they gonna be at you. Now don't cry foul with them. Got them wolves get at your ass, cause that's what they gonna do. If you don't want to get at your ass with a turtleneck and some motherfucking corduroys, then you ain't gotta worry about nothing.
That is.
But the other reality is, for us, for men, if I think you fine, you gonna be finding me fully dressed.
Mm-hmm. Right.
If you look good, you ain't got to be necessarily with everything showing.
Exactly.
What's attractive to me is gonna be attractive whether mm-hmm. you suited and booted from head to toe or right. you come, you know, tit ass out. It's gonna be the same reaction depending on how I look at the female. So
I'm
if
glad
I see
you said
you,
that. I'm really glad you said
and
that.
And you right. have some respectability. You're on your way to work. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna approach you different too. I'm gonna say, excuse me, what's your name? So on and so forth. But if you got everything hanging out, please don't expect me to walk up to you right. like on, you know. Pardon me, I hate to disturb you. Hell nah, you know what I'm saying? So you're going to get that reaction from men. Right. So you have to expect that. You know, he's not going to come up on you like, man, there's my wife right there with half of her areola showing.
You're going to my next point. I want to get Dion's point of view on this before I even bring that next point up. But that was good stuff right there. What you got on the thirst? I know you see it all the time. Being in the fashion industry, yeah. you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know it's heavy out here with the
thirst trap. I mean, it worked for some people. Mm-hmm. You know, like I said, but when you know a lot of these females personally, you know, it's more like a bear trap. You know, you fall into that, you know, you might not get out of it at all. You know what I mean? It might be the wrong trap for you. You know,
might be the wrong trap.
The thirst trap, you know, there's certain different peaks of Instagram and social media. Mm-hmm. A lot of people that got real business are at work.
Right.
So you don't see a lot of thirst trapping at certain peaks. Mm-hmm. But if you're on the Instagram and social media, you know, during the wee hours, like your grandma say, you know,
4 days in the morning,
you might see a lot of traps. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, right. but you'll see roadblocks too if you're riding around late at night.
There you go.
Yeah.
So you know, so the thirst trap might happen like after 2:30 on the AM too.
Yeah, use the thirst trap. So you know, stuff from around 10:30 to around like the 2:30 peak. You know,
after that, from what I've heard, the thirst trap is during those times now, there ain't nothing open up but the Waffle House,
exactly.
the crack house, and some legs.
Mm. That's it.
So, hey, so if you're tracks. Trying to get that, then shit, post it all day. Get them likes, them DMs, them all that shit.
Get something out the deal, though. That's what I'm saying. You got to get something out the deal, you know, right. ladies. You can't just be trapping guys and then just boiling hot dogs. You really got to, you going to do something, you got to do it to the utmost, you know. You know, when you gonna trap a dude, make him trap for a reason. You right. know, you gotta bring something to the table.
I'm glad both of you guys said that, man, because this goes on to my next point. That's Hold on, you got something you want to say?
Go ahead. Fucking around with the thirst trap, it'll get you invited to this party right here that's on my shirt. Uh-huh. There's a part in my pants.
Bend that a little more.
Oh, there's a part in my pants, and you were invited. That's what a thirst trap is like. <that bitch.
laughs> There you go,
better believe that shit.
So I'm glad that you read the statement before, Stone. You know, women out here really showing everything and expecting something different.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? I mean, that's a situation where, you know what, you are what you attract.
Right.
Like, if you out here showing your tits ass all the damn time, you're going to get that kind of guy. Then you want to come back and bash and say, all dudes ain't shit.
That's that 96 Olympic, though. That's what you're going to get. You're going to get that 96 exactly. Flavor Atlanta if you bring in the areola.
You showing me the data. I'm going to treat you as such.
Yeah, I got my USB with me.
If you got it in the window for sale, what am I supposed to do?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
You showing me butt cunt. I want to see butt cunt. That's all I want. That's all I'm saying, man.
That's it. That's all we're saying.
Yeah. Fly trap me. I'm going to tell your answer. So I'm just saying, do y'all feel that, you know, with these women folk out here doing what they're doing, they, you know, dating these women that's out here bullshitting what they like, you got to stop it at some point. You got to stop it.
Well, you know what?
Go for what you want to do with your life.
Well, the other thing now is that, you know, a lot of stuff is getting messed up. I blame reality TV, too, because they're seeing these women cutting the fool, but they latch on to somebody with some money and they use that as a stepping stone to get somewhere else as opposed to wanting to build something on your own. But then all women aren't that lucky. That's a small bundle.
Right.
So you got to think, if you're not in that little small bundle to catch an athlete or what have you, you're going to have to build your own brand and do something for yourself. You're going to have to get that home on your own. Everybody's not going to get lucky. And it's only what? 5,000 dudes playing sports at any given point in time. Right. I mean, like, seriously speaking.
Right.
So if you're not in that, that's a small pool of men for you to try to get your hands on.
But even at that, to add to that, I mean, there's another part of that too, because there's a lot of women. So you have those women that are in competition to try to get those athletes and those entertainers, those ballers, but you also have women that feel like they're in competition to try to latch on to any piece of a good man they can find.
Right.
And it's almost like, now the competition has become the primary focus versus you putting yourself in position to get chose. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And it's just like, if y'all too busy fighting each other, then I ain't gonna worry about choosing none of y'all.
Right.
Cause you ain't even focused on doing what it is that you're supposed to be doing.
Right.
Which is putting yourself in position to get chose.
Mm.
Yeah.
Message.
Yeah. He got deep right
there. Yeah, he did. I mean, it's only
I gotta sit up, you know what I'm saying? Adjust my
man. Because at the end of the day, man, look. And this piggy, this goes around all what we were just talking about just now. The ladies, majority of the time, they be doing all this foolishness. They be what we talking about right here. They got what? They got daddy issues. So I need you to go ahead and fix the, talk to your daddy. If your daddy ain't around, find his ass. Find him. Before you come fool with Condo, find him. All right? Because I don't need you out here crying, talking about all this foolishness, talking about you going to take a dude home, smash him, then you wonder why he don't call you no more.
Right.
Because your daddy wasn't there. Man, look here. Fix that.
They definitely looking for a daddy. Daddy.
Yeah. Come and get your daddy. You want that daddy, daddy here.
And then another thing is that, you know, now we have a whole different paradigm where, and I don't know if you was going to bring this up later, but you have the new, the misunderstanding of what an independent woman means.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Because realistically speaking, none of us need to be independent.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It's something that's forced upon you, not something you should strive to be. You should strive to be, if you're talking, calling yourself a Christian person, you need to have a structure of a family, not you being the only one. It's not okay for you to have kids and not have the fathers in their life. That's something that should be a last resort, not something chosen. Like, well, no, I'm gonna do this on my own. No, that's not okay.
Exactly.
We need a family structure.
Independent,
you know,
woman bullshit, yeah, man.
That's real. I mean,
go ahead.
At the end of the day, once you become a certain age, most theoretically in America, they say you're supposed to be what, 18 years of age. You're considered an adult. You're supposed to be independent at that point anyway. So do your thing. Trust and believe. If you fucking with any kind of real nigga, you ain't got to pop off at the mouth about how independent you are. He going to peek that game. He going to see what it is.
Right.
If you not, he going to think it's bullshit. If you wearing that shit as a crown, as a throne, as a cape,
right,
that's the shit we hate. We don't like that shit. Like, I see what you're doing, Ma. If you're doing your thing, you're making your money, paying your bills, I'm going to see it.
Right.
If you're looking for a man that's going to handle you when you're down and out, he gonna do that. But he don't, if you fucking with a dude that you getting with him only because of the fact that his money, trust me and believe, it's a whole nother side agenda behind it. Trust and believe. If you're paying your stuff, trust and believe, it's a hidden agenda.
Yep.
It's either gonna be, he's gonna be controlling his hell, he's gonna be whooping your ass or something like that.
Just the truth.
But if you fucking with a real man, you're a real woman, you're doing your business, he gonna know it and respect it, and y'all gonna shit jail just like it was supposed to be.
Ladies, you cannot use your, this the thing. Number one, first off, I'm hearing a lot of times with a lot of these females, I'm gonna try to keep it brief, that, you know, they get on this thing where, you know, it's like, okay, well, you know, I'm making my money, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. First of all, that's what the fuck you supposed to be. Okay, you don't get props for doing the shit that you actually supposed to be doing. If you grown, you supposed to be out there making money. Now, that don't use that though as an opportunity to flex in your relationship. You know what I'm saying? Because men, that power struggle shit,
like,
as my man King Beef says, it ain't but one man in this relationship.
Yeah.
Ain't no real nigga having that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's, you're supposed to be at a point where you handle your business, but also be at a point where you can collectively work with your man and not cause a power struggle at home.
Same.
We don't want that shit.
When we come home,
we want peace.
Same.
It ain't about me needing you.
When we come home,
we want peace.
Thank you.
It's not about me needing you or you needing me. It's about us collectively needing each other. And what I need right now is some motherfucking peace.
That's it.
The male, in my opinion, the male should be Michael Jordan. The female should be Scottie Pippen.
Scottie!
Great team, winning championships all day, every day. And I hate to say, I don't like to use God, you know, in different ways, but God should be Phil Jackson, coaching y'all along the way. Period.
Now, see that right there? That's a great analogy.
That was a great layup right there.
Scottie!
Good job to be that case, Scotty.
I need that from you.
Yeah. So,
man, we're going to take a quick break, man. We're going to come back. It's getting hot up in here, man. We're talking about this real life issues. What Black Man Really Think, part two. What's going down right now? Condo TV Live.
And I'm sick of you swoops.
Woo.
Boom.
It's getting real in here, man.
Shots. Hey,
duck down.
Condo TV Live. Y'all make sure y'all come back, man. We going in, man. Y'all stay tuned.
Don't think shit, think pink gators. My Detroit players, Tim's for my hooligans in Brooklyn. Dead right, if they head right, Biggie there, air night. Papa been smooth since days of under rules. Never lose, never choose to. Bruce Cruz who? Do something to us, talk go through us. Girls walk to us, wanna do us, screw us, who us? Yeah, Papa and Pop.
close like Starsky and Hutch. Stick to clutch. Yeah, I squeeze three at your cherry M3. Bang every MC easily. Recently, niggas frontin' ain't saying nothing, so I just speak my peace. Keep my peace. Cubans with the Jesus peace. With my peace. Packing, asking who want it. They got it, nigga flaunt it. That Brooklyn bullshit, we on it.
Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so vain. Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so vain.
I put Hoes in NY onto DKNY. Miami, D.C., prefer Versace.
That's right.
All Philly hoes know it's Moschino. Every cutie with the booty or the coochie. Now who's the real dookie? Meaning who's really the shit? The niggas ride dicks. Frank White pushing six on the Lexus LX 4.5. Bulletproof glass tips if I want some ass. Gon' blast squeeze first. Ask questions last. That's how most of these so-called gangsters pass. At last, a nigga rapping about blunts and bras, tits and bras, menage a trois, sex and expensive cars. I still leave you on the pavement. Condo paid for, no car payment. At my arraignment, no for the plaintiff. Your daughter's tied up in the Brooklyn basement. Face it, not guilty. That's how I stay
guilty.
Richer than richer, so you niggas come and get me.
Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so vain. Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so vain.
I can fill you with real millionaire shit. That's cargo, my cargo. 160, swiftly. Wreck it by your new one. Your crew run, run, run. Your crew run, run. I know you sick of this. Name brand, nigga with flows. Girl, stay heat. Sweet like nigga wrist. So get with this, nigga, it's easy. Girl.
Condo TV Live right now. We sit with this Merlot. We got the fellas up in the building, man.
Yeah, he got us all fancy with this Merlot right here.
Merlot,
man.
Yeah.
In Decatur, they call this Merlot.
See, and you're trying to realize.
Fuck all that. Your blood.
Tony will come with that real shit over there. Like that. Man, when I tell you, man, the fellas is what we do, man. I see a real dude drinking Merlot. That's what it is. And Jaeger 209 Yard. We in the building. Y'all saw the last segment. It's for real over here now. So we got to switch gears. Y'all know y'all hear a song playing in the background. I had one more drink. Luda! College Park, Charter Bannock High School alum as well.
That's why I ain't messing with that Jaeger with him, because I probably would be like,
you know what? If she had all her teeth and she had combed her hair, so she'd be fine by me.
You already know how it goes. So my thing is, a lot of us have, you know, I don't know, you've been married before, right?
Yeah.
You've been married before, right?
Yeah.
Tony, you ain't never been married, right? Shit, no.
Home at grass.
And Dion, you never been married before.
Nah.
So we've all did a dating scene a lot in our, you know, 20 plus years of existence on the planet.
Yeah.
So my question is, because somebody asked me this question personally, said, Condo, you got to let men come on the show. You got to ask this question. So I said, you know what? All right, this is what we're going to do. So she wants to know, how long, like, she always feels that guys wait too long to call after the initial meeting. Like, when a chick give you the number, now, how long before he calls you?
Till the dick get hard.
Like what's the applicable time for a man to call a dude after he get the initial number?
That's the catch 22.
At least a day. At least a day. You don't want to seem too thirsty like you ain't never had nobody.
Don't get too thirsty.
Yeah, a lot of these folks really ain't never had no nice women when they was in school or when the cool guy. You know. Yeah. And if being grown, you know, you'd be thirsty a little bit because you be like, she got something going on. You know, I would have missed the opportunity in my life, you know.
Right.
But you got to sit back and realize that you are a boss, you know, and to make her realize that you got something going on, you know.
At least one day,
I got a deep question. How come she can't call first?
What's wrong with that? For me, it's more so the vibe. I mean, because I've met chicks, and I've met them at the club, and I would promise you, I've had to trick women into telling me their names because I really couldn't remember their name. But there's been some women where we just vibe so well to the point where, like, you know what? I gotta stay on top of this. Yeah. So it varies. To be honest with you, it varies.
Mm-hmm. It depends if you like her a lot.
Right.
Yeah.
Or at least you think you like her. Mm. You know.
So really the vibe got to be on point.
Yeah. So super on point.
It's a feel type of thing.
Man, just don't kill my motherfucking vibe. Just don't kill my vibe. I'll hit you up within 24, 48 hours.
Right.
At least let her get to work the next day.
We need to do a background check.
Yeah. Well, hold on. Depending on how many shots she done had that night now.
Yeah, like I said, you got
to. She went on thirst traps. She done had quite a few shots.
Yeah, you know what
the see, the main questions in the club got to be first name, where you from, where you work. Because then you find out she got to work tomorrow. If not, she say she in the industry, that means she might not really be in the industry. She might just be at home.
She Instagram model.
She Instagram
industry. Instagram flicks are so real.
Yeah, you know. Because the term model was used
real loosely.
Hey, I got some friends over that topic. I lost some Facebook friends over there. I got some of my man. Man, boy.
No, I mean, I think for me, dude, you at least put away 48 hours, man.
Yeah, at least
48 hours.
So hold on, talking about is she dime piece bag super
bad in the dog?
I know you itching.
She tell you she ain't got
I
no kids.
Brothers,
48 hours.
Brothers, we itching right now. You know what I'm saying? But you got to make her at least want to loan for you a little bit. Like, I want to loan for both of us. Give me 2 days. Maybe two days, man.
Man, you're going to have about 50 other niggas hit her up in 2 days.
Yeah, that's what you
want to
do?
I'll say 24. It's a whole day.
That's a whole day.
So you have to call her first, or do you have to? Is it cool to text?
I mean, we live a different life now, so we texting a lot. You know.
So now the 2013 woman, it's cool to text before you call. That
okay,
person.
Man. If she basically, I'm gonna
tell you what though, G. I'm gonna tell you what though, G. If you're a real man, old school, like that's a real like deep bloodline where you raised around some real men, you slick call her, you got her. Cause see, she used somebody texting her off the rip.
Right.
She used a young dude texting her or gonna play emoji games with her, you know. But if you go in and call and see what her personality like over the phone, then you already won.
Yeah. My thing is, I might lose some followers and some potentials for this shit. But for me, if I met you and I'm vibing with you, and I know you've been drinking with me, cause boy, y'all know I'm gonna pour it up. Uh-huh. But if you with me, I'm gonna make sure you got to call you. Hey, look, baby, I wanna make sure you're good tomorrow. Yeah. You get free tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Give me a holler. Mm-hmm. But now if I don't, and I just think you some ratchet shit, and I ain't getting no action at night, you might not hear from me. For
see,
about
like
two,
I say, it's always a motive behind that, and you know. If it's a deep motive behind that, man. Every guy can play it differently.
I like to say something to her about the initial meeting, which is why I don't want to wait 2 damn days. I want to make sure I want to make sure I say something to the fact of, you know what I'm saying, it was great meeting you.
Yeah.
I love, you know what I'm saying, you know something. Yeah, I don't want to wait too late to say like, damn, you know, at least you made an impression on me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm thinking about your ass. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So the 48 hours is the don't get too thirsty, but the 24 or the rapid make sure you got home straight.
48 is the median.
It's the setting y'all met too. It's all that matters. Because if you meet somebody in the club, somebody in the club, to me, that's the worst thing to meet. That's the worst place for me to meet somebody. Because first of all, I can't really hear you. We like what? Mm-hmm. You know, that's the first thing. Secondly, to me, if I'm in the club, I already feel kind of pressured. Like, damn, I only got like 10, 20 minutes before the next dude gonna try to roll up. I gotta do something. So it's like, man, you know, can we step outside or can we have a chat somewhere
else?
Take
you somewhere quiet so you can hear what
so we can really, like, have
that, for me, if that Max Strong, man, that shit ain't got nothing to do with it. She wants you closer and closer. She like you the closer and closer she can get up on you. The more she can hear you.
So for me and my
boy, man, we call that shit lockdown. If we find somebody we like, she done for the night. Like, she with us for the night. She gonna enjoy our conversation.
So
we gonna talk. We gonna drink. We gonna all that stuff. Like, cause see, people talk the club though. But you gotta think, even the best of the best people, the most Christian for the mental club, it may be her friend's birthday.
Yeah.
She may be celebrating promotion. She might not be there all the time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Just that right night you meet her, you gotta go in. You never know where you may be that one at. So pay attention to what she's saying. Look at how she carrying herself.
Yes, sir.
And period. Work from that point. That's when that game come from. That's when you ain't new to this shit. Yeah. You've been
new to this shit
a minute.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say all the 25 plus up here, so we know a little bit of what's
going on. I say the grocery store the best place to meet somebody.
Grocery store?
Because you know she going to be cooking. If you look at what's in the basket now, she got a lot of microwave dishes, you might want
to
bypass.
She young. She young.
You said grocery store?
I like to eat on the grocery store. No.
Man, if she got two bags, she got motherfucking food stamps, man. I want her.
Oh, no.
No,
if you going to be at the grocery store, man, pay attention to what's in the bucket, dude.
Yeah.
You have to.
You know what I'm saying?
Man, I see them chicks on food stamps, they would make you think they're loyal. They be having steaks,
Lobster, but you can tell what she got on, and she on food stamps. Like, you know what I'm saying? You can tell by a woman's outfit if you really pay attention. What she, you know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
Because if she come in and she just kind of look nice, her well kept, but she not being too overly sexy.
Like them leggings.
That
shit.
Yeah,
right. She come in. What about the thin ass leggings?
Okay, no. That shit tricky. I'm in the car business, man. I've learned you cannot judge a book by its cover. The guy who I've seen put out the most money at a car lot looked like he got. Like he ride donkeys to where he got them going for that man. About 8 bands.
Yeah,
his overalls look like straight boo boo. Can't judge the book by a club because sometimes people overdress to impress.
It always go both ways.
Some people overdress to impress.
You're right, because I met somebody in the industry. I met Tommy Mottola in the bathroom one time. I had no idea he was Tommy, other than the fact that two big dudes all of a sudden stopped. If they hadn't came in, I would have never known it was him.
It was another guy I just met not long ago. He did some songs for damn near everybody for So So Def. I promise you, man, this dog looked like he was doing part-time for a temp service.
Yeah.
But I thought he was bullshit. I looked him up. I didn't never heard his name before. I forgot his name. I looked him up on Google that day. He's the real deal.
Yeah. A woman ain't gonna do that though.
Yeah. Real deal.
She ain't gonna down dress it just
bullshit.
But I'm saying the ones that depend on her.
If she used to money, yes, she will. Mm. If she used to money,
yeah, she got to be born in it though. And it ain't too many of us really just born in it like that. So you mean the average chick? Chances are she gonna dress to part, or she gonna play a role. You know, she ain't gonna just dress it down and say I got a lot. Mm. A woman is more vanity. They more in the mirror. They more self conscious about themselves. But we put them in a society where they think they should be like this, you know. A dude, you know, he'll kick it with the same jeans on for months and there Sundays and have thousands and thousands in them pockets. A woman ain't finna wear the same thing, or even I ain't never seen that in my 25 years. I can put it like that.
I have a question because I had a conversation with one of my friends earlier, and she was, and Stone mentioned, we talked about the grocery store and we were talking about food. And I asked her, I said, well, if I'm in a relationship with you, let's just say, fellas, let's just say you spend the night at over your lady house, you know, saying y'all done did whatever the night before, you getting up, getting ready to leave to go to work, y'all both leave to go to work at the same time, right? So I said, in an old relationship, in a relationship that I was in, when I was with my woman, she made sure before I left the house that I had something to eat.
She wanted you to come back. She was smart.
And I did.
Yeah, they're like a dog.
Every time. but listen, what I was telling her was, she was like, she got an attitude with me and was like, well, I ain't doing that. And I was like, see this right here is what's wrong. This right here is what's wrong with this 2013 women. I know you're watching too. And again, you know what I'm saying? But it's serious. But it's just look, man, it's like, listen, you looking good and all that shit is great.
Wonderful.
Taking care of home is important.
Very much
you
so.
Got to do, you know, something that's going to make your man come back home. Yeah. First of all, in the city that we live in, is ridiculous ratio.
Mm. Right.
Okay, you either play on the other fence, you going to chain gang in a few months, you know, or you just really ain't got shit together. So if you got a little bit of shit going on, you know, chances are you can find what you're looking for or think, you know.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know, it ain't going to be that difficult.
That's what I'm saying, man. Like, and a lot of women, I mean, switching gears a little bit, I mean, that just brings up the topic of, you know, dating for potential. You know what I mean? I think it's not just women dating for potential. We got to date for potential, too, at some point.
I damn sure changed my whole thing.
Yeah. You know? Look at the woman who's working towards her goals. You know
exactly.
What I mean? The one who, I mean, hell, you might go to Metro, but you got damn working Waffle House. But hell, I know
if she got all her teeth at Waffle House, she good.
She got all her teeth and she got good credit. You know what I'm saying? Like, there you go.
The thing for me is this, like, a lot of people, not the potential thing, but if me, I'm a firm believer in this because sports raised me. It got me where I was able to go through school and stuff. At certain points, you're going to peak. Mm-hmm. Some people, you might meet this person right here. She might have already peaked. That's it. That's as good as she going to goddamn get. But if I got Keisha hungry. She got to, she biting like bottles in a lake.
Yeah.
She got the upgrowth. So I mean, you have to kind of, that's when your wisdom comes in there, because some people, that's all they're gonna get. They don't hit the top of the line. Use NFL bus, NBA bus, music bus. Mm. They hit that key song or that key game, that key MVP, and then you hear nothing else from them again. They are peaked. Some people are still peaking. You gotta look for that people that's going to the upside of the mountain. Mm. Straight like that.
Up the side of the mouth, man.
Up the side of the goddamn mouth.
This is getting real in here right now. This is really, really good. It's real good, man. Condo TV at the door right now. It's now taking the place. Shit. Hey, man, we in here, man. What Black Men Really Think Part 2 is crazy. I got Tonio. I got my dog Simon Stone. I got Dion in the building. DJ Sings. We up here right now, man. Bree over there looking like she about to say, y'all ain't talking about shit over here.
Mm. Beef with this bitch.
No, we in here right now, man. Condo TV live.
One, that's the one right there. She giving us the, no, the if the, I could slap all of them, I would do the straight. She's looking like she's
all over here.
Like the Three Stooges.
It's going down, man. Kind of keep it the dog. We in here right now, man. Make sure y'all come back. Hey, don't go nowhere. Stay tuned. We come back with it, man.
Turn down.
Kind of
TV.
Yeah, let's go.
I'm there for you anytime you need me. For real, girl, it's me in your world. Believe me, nothing make a man feel better than a woman. Queen with a crown that be down for whatever. There are few things that's forever. My lady, we can make war or make babies. Back when I was nothing, you made a brother feel like he was something. That's why I'm with you to this day, boo, no frontin'. Even when the skies were gray, you would rub me on my back and say, maybe it'll be okay. Now that's real to a brother like me, baby. Never ever give my cootie away. And keep it tight, alright? And I'ma walk through the door so we can live in a fat ass crib with thousands of kids. Well, like, you don't need a ring to be my wife. Just be there for me and I'ma make sure we be living in the effing lap of luxury. I'm realizing that you didn't have to fuck with me, but you did. Now I'm going all out, kid, and I got mad love to give. You my nigga.
One look at you, and it was plain to see you are my destiny. With you, I spend my time. I'll dedicate my life. I'll sacrifice to you.
I gotta love Jones for your body and your skin tone. 5 minutes alone, I'm already on the phone. Plus I love the fact you got a mind of your own. No need to shop around, you got the good stuff at home. Even if I'm locked up north, you in the world rocking 3/4 of cloth. Never showing your stuff or cool. It be true, me for you, that's how it is. I be your Noah, you be my wins. I'm your mister, you my missus. With hugs and kisses, Valentine cards and birthday wishes. Please, be on another level of planning. Understanding the bond between man and woman and child, the highest elevation, cause we above all that romance crap. Just show your love. Suck up on these. And you don't stop.
Bring them out, bring them out, bring them out. It's hard to yell when the barrel's in your mouth.
Come on.
Bring them out, bring them out.
Hey.
Bring them out, bring them out.
Yeah.
Bring them out, bring them out.
Hey.
Bring them out, bring them out.
VIP coming live from the VIP.
Condo TV Live, we are back in the building right now, and of course, you know, this is What Black Men Really Think Part 2, and I got the whole team with me. Once again, I got Dion, in case you didn't know, right here to my left. I got Simon Stone over here. I got my dog, King Beef, a.k.a. Tony O'Terry over here. Of course, we got DJ Sings in the building. It's, man, it's real over here. It's real over here. So, you know, I mean, and you know, I have to do this because this is Condo TV at the dark now. So, it's about to switch up a little bit. It's about to get a little real.
Hey, bro,
we about to tell, we about to, you know, really, really tell you about how it really is out here in these streets and in these sheets.
When it get dog, when it get dog,
when it get dog out here.
So, ladies, pay attention to this right here. I'm telling you, pay attention to this. You don't want to miss this right here.
We about to go like Atlanta.
We going there. I'm talking about Magic City Monday there. Yeah, that's where we going. Yeah, Onyx.
Yeah, well.
Well.
So, fellas, I got to ask y'all this question right here. We all talked about what kind of woman we probably would love to go after. You know, the woman that's dressed appropriately at all times. The woman that, you know what I'm saying, is a virtuous woman, got her goals and shit together. And all that sound well and good. But what about at nighttime?
What about makeup
what about when the time for the makeup to come off, man, and it's time to get nasty?
Okay.
See, we want a woman in the streets. Luda said it best, for the freak in the sheets.
Got to.
Yeah.
You got to be comfortable.
You got to know how to turn it on and off. Man, fellas, turn what's up. What's up, man?
Hey, would you like first. My nasty comments first?
Let's go. I mean, it don't. Go. Anybody can jump at that.
The tone. Let's do it.
Because I'm sick of this. I need to.
I ain't going to do no name dropping in like that because my ex girlfriend was. I ain't gonna lie to you. I will refer her to anybody. She's a great girl. Everybody sighting this watching the turtle 100 meter dash in the Olympics. That shit was boring.
Bar.
Damn. But she was a good girl, good person. Me, I'm a freak. I'm nasty. This shit is me all day, every day. I'm nasty as hell. I like freaking stuff. But I don't want you just doing freak stuff with everybody. I want to be surprised. Like, I want to come home and think I'm finna do some old cute, romantic shit.
Mm-hmm.
And thinking I'm finna be on some old nice, humble, Luther Vandross move, love making. Then you turn up, go Luke freak nasty on me. That's what I want to goddamn do. Yeah. That's how I like it. Like, I want to come home one day and you done snuck and put a pole in my goddamn room. That kind of shit.
Oh, that pole. That sneak pole.
Yeah. Most definitely.
Like that.
I fuck with it.
Ooh. Yeah.
All right, man. I mean, because this is one of them things where, you know, a lot of women get this thing misconstrued. You know, they don't understand that you got to be able to turn this thing on and off. And look at the nastier. I know for me, let me speak for Condo. The nastier, the better.
Don't be no hoe, be my hoe. That's my motto. Don't be no hoe, be my hoe.
You know what? I like a woman to make you. She make it. Like, no, I don't care. Mm-hmm. You thought you was tired, but you finna do this.
Ooh.
I need,
but
that energizes a bunny.
That's a chance.
I got the matrix. Holler at him.
Listen,
you meet your girl, right? You meet your girl, and she's just like the ultimate freak that you want.
Mm-hmm.
Chances are, she was somebody else, like super freak. He had to turn.
I don't
like,
want to fuck somebody before.
You know what I mean? So like, it be a scary sometimes when she too freaky, cause you like, damn, like what shit you really didn't learn from my boy prior.
Right.
That you really ain't even brought out the closet yet. Now, I mean, like, he really could just, the football team could have just been dropping, sacks off in you. How you land, nigga. Whoa, you could have really lured that man.
And you right about that, but if she had was with that right one dude,
It
turned her out.
But she ain't going to read it right away.
That's like, I never meet, for me personally, I never brag on my Johnson, because I could be dead ass serious, like, because I could have been with one. Okay, you take two chicks. Chick A, she'd have been with 100 dudes, and she'd be like, "Oh man, you got the biggest dick in the world." But then I could be this one other chick who'd been with one other guy, but I fell short of his category. Nigga, you ain't shit. Hey, it happens. So that's why I don't buy it, because I don't know what ain't checked up Carfax. I don't know what she had before me.
See what happens at that point? You know what happens at that point, right? When you meet that woman, when you know you don't fail short, that when she get in the car, you get that what? That BDR. That bad dick report.
That's bullshit.
Hold up.
First off, when the women gonna get some bad
pussy report?
I'm trying to figure out when that coming.
Who don't give it? Shouldn't me?
So you gotta start ranting like Gucci. What we gotta start doing is ranting on like Twitter. Go on, fuck it.
Well, you better
go on
to
social media. You ain't gotta say a name like Guwap, but you can put a business fuck out there.
That's bullshit.
You know what? Let me tell you what. See, there are certain double standards that you dare not cross.
Uh-huh.
Because you know what? Here's the thing. Like, for example,
don't say it.
Let's be real. We're gonna keep it 100. A bigger woman can dog a little woman, but a little woman can't do the reverse. We can't say a lot bad on women.
No.
A woman right now, every woman that we know can get on Twitter right now and say, he ain't shit, his mama ain't shit, his mama's a punk. But if you say one thing, they gonna say, you know what, he got a problem with women. There's something wrong
He may have, he women can't bashing. Say nothing.
Boy, you better follow me on goddamn Facebook, Instagram, because I just don't give a fuck.
I'm just saying.
I don't give a fuck. Hell no.
Right now, it's a woman right now that will post, my baby daddy ain't nothing, I'm taking care of this kid on my own. Indeed. But if I post, which I have been the dude taking care of my kid on my own, I said something, and the women be like,
You deserve your Father's Day gift.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But it's different when I say, like, well, you know, I got my daughter on my own. It's stressful. Well, that's what you're supposed to do. You a man, ain't you?
Yeah, but I've been trying hard.
I did get hit with that.
Have you seen my post on Happy Mother's Day? I go in on the motherfucker.
No, I mean, I'm telling you. I mean, for real. Like, for example, on Father's Day, women say Happy Father's Day to me. Let a single man do that same thing. All hell will break loose. Twitter will break down. That shit will fall apart. It'll just explode.
Man, you know I go in on that ass. Look, man.
First of all, we need to dispel the myth.
Yeah.
I know I might lose like 2 million followers, and I ain't even got 2
million.
But
I'm
just going to say it.
Not yet.
But we need to dispel the myth, because there are too many of you females out here saying, first of all, listen, just like you don't want dudes to brag on that shit, This whole thing that you've been doing, every one of you don't have the platinum pussy. I'm here to tell you.
Some of that shit.
I'm sorry. That's an aluminum foil pussy.
I'm like, hey, man, I had to cut you off, but fuck that. I'm getting good at this. The older I get, you know, your girl running to me.
Yeah,
she might have some issues. You
know? It's just like that, though.
It's just like that. You got to keep it real with yourself, man. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I dress nice. I feel like I dress nice. I feel like I present myself well.
In case y'all didn't know, my man got the 1996.
Man, when your grandma was stripping that magic. Most of you folk grandma yawn for real. Like,
yeah, that's the Izzy. Y'all remember the little mascot? That's the Izzy right there.
Nah, I mean, but yeah, I'm going to keep y'all up, gang.
I ain't never thought about that.
You
he a wardrobe stylist, man.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
I don't fit in that plug though.
No, listen, that's real shit. That's real shit, because y'all need to understand that. Be a little bit more humble about yourself. You know what I'm saying? Because if the truth ever really came out about some of y'all wouldn't like us.
Hell no.
You know what I'm saying? While you up there talking about bad dick reports.
Hey, if I put that bad smell
bad
report on you.
Report.
Hold on.
Okay,
I'm going to
get you one of them. Get you one of these.
That's the one right
what?
There.
But let me do one of them.
Right,
that's the
average. Most niggas scared to admit this shit, but man, I've faked so many goddamn fucking orgasms and shit. I mean, I got them sense, man. I'm like, ooh, it's so good. Going to the bathroom, jack off a fish. I saw the mama.
Hey, man, that ain't really my MO. I'm going to make myself do what I need to do.
In the bathroom.
I'm gonna find my chick. I gotta go
if
find
it take, me. If it take 30 minutes or 2 days, we gotta get this done.
We gotta get it done.
I ain't gonna be walking around.
I am now. Hold on. So y'all ain't never got bored with no pussy.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Have y'all ever let a bitch? Have y'all ever let her know y'all got bored the pussy?
No. Listen, no.
Hold on.
I got you. Now this raises my next point right here. Damn it. What about these ladies that you look at that set the thirst trap, and then when you finally get them, they lazy in bed?
Listen, let me say something. Watch this right here. I'm finna help you with that. I'm finna help you. You hold it like this here, and you force her to move. Either she gonna move with you and get annoyed by it,
sir,
something is gonna happen.
Sir, that
you show her what
rape.
You need. I'm like, hey, man. I'm holding him. Come on, bring
can't
it on in.
I
don't just need some direction.
That's
though.
It.
Right. That's all. You
get lost without direction. You get lost without direction.
I'm helping
you.
Hold on,
this is where you need to be going.
I'm almost 30 years old. I got a kind of time, man. I need you to know what's going on, man.
I feel you, but a lot of folks.
I need you to get with the program.
A lot of folks didn't learn the two-step.
I don't like to have to ask too many questions.
Everybody didn't learn it.
Doing sex in my mind. Like, if I had to ask, why if I'm from the back, why the fuck your back doing all this bullshit? Get your fucking back with the curve.
Down.
Why your back doing this?
No.
Why you ain't... You know what I'm saying?
Questions.
I mean, I'm just I'm telling to myself in my mind.
Yeah, I love
like,
questions. Who puss is this? What's my name?
No, not that. Not, no, I'm just talking about like, why is she ain't doing the shit that I need her to do right now?
You need the girl to be already free. No, for real. Like,
that's what you get lost without direction. Give some direction. You a director.
But Stone, I need you here. Man,
like I got drum major. Got it. Get with it.
My point is that, like I just told Dion over here, like, man, look, we all almost 30 plus. Look here, man, I ain't got that kind of time. You had poked the bill around the merry-go-round a couple times by now. Why, like Cena just said, hey, I'll smash you from the back.
I'm going
to
say
and we like your head to be down.
But then we'll hold out on you.
And you get
like, so we'll hold out on you to make you think that this good two-shoe girl.
Because what it is,
and they go ham that week.
She has told me.
You'll be like, damn, why you do that the first week?
Differently of me.
That's it.
I'm really thinking differently of
me.
Hey, man.
I'm with you because what I have been told, that what they do is, depending on like let's just put it this way. The first time y'all smash might be totally completely different than the fifth time. Yeah. Because she's deciding how hard she want to go the first time y'all do it. Because she don't want you to think that she a hoe.
You know why?
Not that we care. You know we fucking anyway.
And not just that.
You know why though?
But like
bitches
this,
got a song called "These women, Bitches Ain't Shit," and that's what the fuck they be trying to trick your
and
ass.
And then some women know they got that snapper, so they know they got to step you into it. They
You hanging all outside.
Yeah, but you'll be looking for a broad daylight with a flashlight. Like, have you seen her? This her right here. I need her right now. Yeah. She got to step you into that snapper.
Hey,
she
man.
She got that Erykah Badu. You know what I mean?
Hold on.
Got that Erykah Badu.
That's something totally different.
No, I ain't saying that. But you know Erykah must have. Listen, let's look at like
that
spectrum. Let's look at two spectrum. You got Halle Berry, who everybody will admit one of the most beautiful women, right? She can't keep a man.
It ain't Fido.
Because she don't.
She ain't got that snap. But Erykah Badu have a dude in Atlanta with a furry Kango, some damn Timberland, and some damn crochet pants in 105 degree weather. Like she got something that make a dude move.
No, but you know Erykah Badu ain't crazy. Halle Berry is fucking lost in the head.
Yeah, but I'm saying though, no, I saw Common. I ain't even joking about this. I saw Common on MTV doing the interview. Uh-huh. He was cool as a fan till they mentioned Erykah Badu.
He
was like, yeah, you know what I'm saying, and you know the new album is coming out. I'm working with Pharrell a little bit. It's all good. Uh-huh. How's Erykah? You talk to her? Well, look, man, I'm saying. She's my best friend. It was more than just something with her. That's some snapper right there. Ooh, but that's what she done.
The snapper.
You know what I'm saying?
Hold on, rewind. What do I want to do?
That's what you call that pull out.
And you text her, I'm thinking about
that's
you.
That's when you call your daddy in the morning.
On the way down there.
I'm still shaking.
No.
I'd have been asleep twice since then. I'm still shaking.
It's always that one. And it's crazy because the thing about it is, which is the next question, fellas, like, is sex really that important?
What?
Yes.
It's very important. It like,
and let me rephrase that. It's good sex.
Hell, motherfucking, definitely.
Mm. Like Ted driving a car, like you know if you got badass credit, you know, but you still gonna go to the car lots and you'll kick the boot, you know, like you got a sack on you.
Right.
You Ted drive the cars you want to drive in, you know what I mean? But when you get your sack right, you know I'm gonna come back and get this money. Right. My money right, so I feel like the young ladies are the same way. Even if your shit really ain't together like she want it. Mm. If she let you taste her, you hit her one couple of times, you like, hey man, she really got something I want to invest in.
Right.
You know? Good sex is very important. For me personally, I think there's two main reasons that most men cheat. One is the goddamn freak ain't in the bed.
Well,
and the other thing, because your woman is not really relating to you, she's really relating everything to herself. She's focusing everything on herself. So,
you know what?
If you got me,
I need one that roll up. You can roll weed. We got a damn good ass.
What the hell is going on with me? Then we goddamn good, but if you, the only thing you care about is you and your bab ass pussy and all the other bullshit. I got time for that, man.
Listen, like that ain't if the relationship is quote unquote, if it's gonna be
80-20. If 20% is bad sex, you can best believe ain't nobody gonna sacrifice that shit. No. That's a big ass.
Hey man, niggas cheating I need off the strength of the cheating game, like all the sport.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, we cheating because we are, well, we located shooting this Condo TV live, really. You know, like I say, man, whew, our options are crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what? But I'm gonna take it a step further because this is one of them things that a lot of women ask, why do men cheat? Mm-hmm. What happens? You know something? It's a flip side to it. Now, leaving the sexual part out totally, a lot of times, men need the same things that women need at a base level. Mm-hmm. We all forget that. A lot of times it's all like, oh, men, da, 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 da. But a lot of times the women will get in a position with a guy, they have him and they know he there, and they get to a point they forget his other needs outside of the bedroom. She might still drop the cheeks on him every night. But then it's the other things that he needs that get totally ignored. Now she busy with her career, or she busy with
that.
This.
And that's why, and like, that's you why know, most men... People that say that, they say most men cheat at work. That's because you are at work with a woman all day who relates to your
yeah. At least that
to what you
and
got
she
going
listening
on.
To you. You know
she
what I'm saying?
She relates to you. She know what's going on. She know how to fuck the man manager fucking with you. She know all that shit. She gonna listen to you. Mm-hmm. Go out for half an hour and end up with a happy ending.
Believe it or not, with a happy ending.
I want to say this. Yeah. Believe it or not, all men are not walking around with the little red thing sticking out. They peen all the time trying to hump everything in sight. We just not. A lot of times it's a thing where we need attention too. Right. But she like your woman. You come home from work. Hey babe, how are you? How the fuck are you? You left a shoe in the middle of the shoe. You don't know what type of day I'm your man you. Had. You didn't see how he was doing. Ooh. First nothing. You just went slam off when he walked in the door. Yeah. You don't know, was he stressed at work?
Exactly.
Did he get pulled over by the cop? Exactly. Did he get, you know, did something happen? Did something happen?
Just competition, you know, for no reason.
Yeah.
A friend of mine the other day told me. He said, you know what, man? I play poker. All right. That's one of the number one thing I like to do in my life when I'm not doing whatever. So I'm one of my poker buddies. He was like, man, you know what? I came home. We newlywed. Been married probably about 8 months now. He came to the poker party. He was kind of looking distraught. I said, man, are you good, man? What's up? He said, man, you know, we just moved to a new house. I said, all right, dude. He said, I took the initiative. I took a day off from my real job because I knew when we moved into our house, we had a whole bunch of boxes set up and everything like that. I took the initiative to go ahead on and unpack boxes and set the living room up the whole nine yards because that's something I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So she comes home from working. First thing that she says, I don't like the way that's set up.
Mm-hmm.
So immediately it's like, hey, how you doing?
Yeah, exactly.
I like what I'm glad you unpacked. Yeah. Oh my, that's awesome. So that's immediate cause for turn up immediately.
Exactly.
Well, for me, my personal take on that is it's all about setting expectations.
Mm-hmm.
One of the last young ladies, we weren't in a relationship, but we dealt with each other strongly. And I know she came from previous relationships where it was a lot of domestic, but it was verbal, physical abuse, where to a point where I asked, I said, why? I've heard a lot of your past. Why you haven't, you know what I'm saying, experienced that with me?
Mm-hmm.
She's like, because I know not to try you like that. Women going to do what you're, it, but matter of fact, I'm going to say anybody going to let you going to do what you allowed them to do.
Mm.
You got to set them in space. If you too passive early on, guess what? When you get more commitments, you're going to become even more passive. She's going to expect you to be even more passive.
Mm.
You got to set the foundation. Let them know what time it is, what you expect for you being as a man and her being as a lady. That's why I preach on roles. A lot of people don't respect roles, but
you got
I was raised
got
by my grandparents.
You got to
lay them roles.
Like, you see that reposting the Ike Turner app. Reposting.
My girl ain't
really
you.
Be living by that, you know. What I mean?
The creed.
You think she ain't care for that at all?
Hey, man, I ain't playing with you. Like
I turned and said, you can't have no ends in your Nikes.
No, man.
Only Nike chicken.
You gotta say Nike. Hey, man, this is Condo TV Live. We are coming to the end part of the show, man. We had a good time tonight, man. When I tell you. We ain't even get to all the juice and all the
stuff. Yeah, like part damn. Three coming.
We're going to have to do part three.
It sounds like the part three coming, fellas.
Do part
three. Man, shit.
Yeah.
I'm about to go live on my Instagram right now. I'm going to do about goddamn 60 seconds of right about 60 different 15-second segments of what the fuck else I had to say.
Exactly.
Exactly. By the way, at KingBeef81 on Instagram, Twitter, everything, whatever the hell you
he
want to be on.
He went that far, he said that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. So hold on. Before we even do all that, winter boot season is coming. Winter boot season is coming.
Now, I'm King Beef. I got boos all year round. Man.
Are we all taking applications or what?
I posted mine not long ago. If you want to see my Instagram, go about 2 weeks ago. I got a good little boot application. Don't come with no bullshit because I peep bullshit and I'll shit you back out the toilet. So give me the real stuff. You might have a chance.
Exactly. Hey,
Do the women need to be out here updating their resumes? What's up?
You definitely gotta be up there updating your resume. Make sure your shoes ain't from Baker's. Make sure your heels and shit staying on because it's gonna get cold outside. The ice is coming. It's gonna be a bad winter for y'all hoes that got the bad shit going on. You know, Celine bags ain't for everybody. Get your sack up. You know, wait on your time to shine, baby. Go get your point of view. Only thing I'm saying there, man, I'm done with the shenanigans and the swoops.
Mm-mm.
You know what I mean? All the Instagram boppers. I done had it.
Can you break down the swoop real quick? What is the swoop?
10 or more. You had more than 10 drives
so
on you?
So if she's had sexual relations with more than 10 dudes?
Definitely in a month's time. You know, you got to slow down.
That motherfucker bald-head scallywag, boy.
Bald-head scallywag.
Y'all going to be a more puppet than that.
Hey, man. You got to slow down. You know, in the life we live in right now, this is Atlanta. I mean, everybody see a lot of gold jewelry, women choosing hard, then they usually choose. You know what I mean? Got starter kits. Mm. They come with these rappers, and you know, and they bopping around, man. I see y'all in these studios, man. Mm. Y'all better stop these video shoots. I'm looking at you.
Ooh,
don't think I don't see you on my timeline. I see you unfollowing too, man. I keep up with y'all.
What a boo. What you got? Are you good? You straight? Stone said he good. I ain't gonna flush it out. Straight.
I
got a yearly boo.
You know, no, check this out. Check this out. You do this, you know what happened? You get in a lot of trouble. You get in a lot of trouble.
Yeah. Boy, that's smart.
What's wrong with a little bit of trouble?
Hey, two of the greatest men that ever walked this earth got a lot of trouble. Jesus Christ and Dr. Martin Luther King. I like trouble, goddammit. Want some trouble? Goddamn, tweet me and Instagram me at King Beef 81 hashtag LLKB. Ladies love King Beef, goddammit.
Oh, man, he in full King Beef mode right now. DJ Z, winnable season, what's up? Applications? Hey, man. Going in?
Hey, all my information is on my shit. Y'all know what to do.
All right, man. Kind of TV Live.
That nigga just hum at a woman. And he's straight. He ain't got to do all that.
You already know what it is, man. All that. We had a good ass show tonight, man. What Black Men Really Think Part 2 was an absolute success. Before we get out of here, we got to let everybody know where they can follow y'all at on the Twitters, on the Instagram. I'm going to start with Dion, man. Where they can get at you at?
Hey, man, y'all can get at me at J-U-N-K-Y, J-A-R-V-A-E. Mm-hmm. Best style y'all probably going to see, man. Real, upbeat, positive young Black man trying to do something with my life, man. Stay tuned.
Stone, what you got?
Decatur Stone. I'm on Instagram and on Twitter. Actually, Friday night, I'm performing at Wonder Root, part of the No Fest. Y'all come out if you can. We'd love to see everybody there. Let's politic. It's going to be a lot of rock and hip hop stuff. I'm actually doing hip hop that night, not gonna have a full band with me. I'm gonna be straight ahead MCing, but
okay.
About to do something with this man Iende right here. I got some stuff, boy. Woo, boy.
About to be crazy.
Woo. Y'all ain't hush ready. Y'all ain't ready.
Tony O'Terry, what you got for us, man?
I'm gonna hit y'all with a good little smooth little King Beef shit. Lip bite on y'all. And if y'all are really looking for the style fashion guru, only thing I need for you to do is put on some baby oil and some high heels and some FMB. Because what's the September, October? Them FMB, them fuck me boots about to come out. I advertise all day and day. I'm going to see if y'all can.
Drop scoot down. You gotta drop.
No, I don't want to drop it low. That's
I'm saying for the camera, dude. I ain't saying no down.
Not like that.
Can
you see the back right there?
Dip down some more.
You got it.
Damn, man. Look at
all
this shit.
LLKB. Follow me. Fuck with me. Instagram. Fun as fuck. Crazy as fuck. But if your feelings are sensitive, you ain't got tough skin, you might not want to fuck with me because you want to slap me when you see me in the street, but I'll beat your ass.
You already know. DJ Scenes, man. What's good? Bree, come on back over here.
DJScenes.com, man. That's it. Food Truck Park Friday. I'll holler at y'all, man.
Hey, man, this kind of TV we in here right now. I got a brand McCall Bree back over here.
You want me to get up?
No, oh, yeah.
You're good.
And ladies, this is what you consider sexy without being slutty.
Boom.
She's very sexy, dressed real classy, but ain't no scallywag.
Have anything to say? You guys are cool. I'm good.
Good.
Yeah.
Where they can follow you at, though?
They know where they can follow me.
They don't know. Well,
yes,
I don't know.
They do.
Well, can you tell them?
At Really22 and wherever, Instagram, freaking Twitter, Facebook, whatever, same thing.
I still got my MySpace and Black Planet, y'all.
Hey, you got Cottage Club. Hey, it's Condo TV Live. We had an amazing show tonight, man. What Black Man Really Think was off the chain. Make sure that this Friday y'all come party with us at the Atlanta Food Truck Park, 1850 Alman Road. Food Truck Friday, hosted by your boy Condo. Music by DJ Scenes. Follow your boy on Twitter and Instagram at Condo with him. C-O-N-D-O-I-S-H-I-M.
Tap Productions.
It's only the beginning, man. Shout out to the whole team in the building. Shout out to Tap Productions. Shout out
Needle.
Shop Marketing Group. Shout out Robert Petillo Law Firm. It's Needle. Crazy right now. The team is so real. We had an amazing time. Always remember this. This is what I say before I get out of here. It's always about love, positivity. Don't never stop chasing your dreams, man. It's Condo TV Live. See y'all next week.
That's it.
Who did?
Guess I'm trying to three that. Never ever ever serve a nigga way sleep at. These DHs go, nigga, you ain't trying to see that. See my suicide watch.